make it clear.
I got the Lord on my side, and with him I'm gon' ride. Yeah. I ain't never scared,
never scared.
I ain't never scared.
Hey.
I got the Lord on my side, and with him I'm gon' ride. I ain't never scared,
never scared.
I ain't never scared.
Greetings, saints, with the love and peace of our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, also known as Jesus Christ. Bless his name, for he is good and his mercy endures forever. We welcome you back to God's Cup of Blessings Youth Ministries. Our Elyon, also known as our Most High God, and I will be doing this and introducing different names of our Father like Jehovah Jireh and Jehovah Rapha as I go along. He is your host, and I am your co-host, Shepherdess Catherine Hunter Williams. Welcome once again. Before we begin this teaching today, let us all pray in one spirit and in agreement. All right, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For we walk by faith and not by sight. Thank you. My friend and God, Holy Spirit, give me a word from my Father to lift up Jesus to your young people today. Move me out of the way, Holy Spirit. Let me decrease as you increase within me and glorify our Lord Jesus Christ. Prick those young people's hearts who are watching our program today to hear our Father's word and be saved and become a disciple of Jesus Christ. Open their understanding to receive a revelation about Jesus Christ's gospel of grace. And I thank you, my Father, for giving me this opportunity to teach our young people about the good news of the gospel of the grace of Jesus Christ in his all-powerful and majestic name. Amen and amen and hallelujah. Praise him. Have you ever noticed, excuse me, because I like to lost my breath then. So many things have been happening and I'm kind of just moving so fast and I got to pull myself down to this. And I had to drive in the rain. I'm scared of driving right now. But I'll talk about that a little later. Have you ever noticed that when you're talking about Jesus to someone who knows him for themselves, how lifted up you become? It's such a wonderful conversation that you have with them. It's like you just get happy all inside because you know that they know who Jesus is and you know who Jesus is. And it's just such a peaceful feeling when you leave that person because you don't talk so much about Jesus. And it's just, you know, the Lord said if you lift him up before, he will lift you up before men. Y'all kind of know what I'm talking about. So when we out here talking and we just discussing and I get in the presence of someone and they get to talking about Jesus and we get to talking and what he's done for us, it's just so awesome. And it's just a piece of that's within you from knowing who he is and who you are to him. Hallelujah. Okay. That's why today I'm going to take our young people to a new and higher height spiritually and mentally, because some of you are still living in that old dimension, your past. We're going to lead you into a higher level of getting to know your high priest, Jesus Christ, who is the author and finisher of your faith. Amen. Now, throughout the rest of this program, let the glory of Jesus Christ be upon you and bless you. I will be teaching the next few programs. I guess I'm starting another series about the gospel of Jesus Christ's grace versus the laws of Moses. And you know there, that law written by Moses, it's a whole lot more to that than we've ever been taught in church. At this point, I want y'all to speak this prayer with me. And when you're ready, I'm going to hope you say, I'm going to just say amen, and we're going to just start speaking it. All right. Lord, I need to draw from you. I present all of my needs to you today. I need you to minister to me and to all of my needs. I cannot, but you can. Thank you, my Lord Jesus, and amen. Simple prayer, but a strong and powerful prayer. I want you all to know, young people, that as I'm teaching you about Jesus Christ's gospel of grace and what his finished works up on the cross did for you and for me, that I'm also learning and getting an understanding about his grace myself. It's kind of new for me because I never really heard it in the church, but I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm learning some new things about His grace that I never heard before. His grace was never really truly taught to me in the church. You know, we know about Jesus and we know about that thing called Easter, which they need to just get it out their mind and mouth and start saying Resurrection Sunday. But all I was taught were some of the laws of Moses. Did you know there were 613 laws of Moses in the Bible, and that's not including the Ten Commandments? In the book of John 1:17, if you want to go with me to it, get your pads and pencils out, because I do give scriptures as I go along, because there is some emphasis from me, but I also like you to get the word of God so you know it's from Him. Mostly from Him, basically. So get your pads and pencils out so you can write these scriptures down. This is in the book of John 1:17. And it said, "For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ." Go with me to the book of Proverbs 4:7. Proverbs come right after Psalms. Proverbs 4:7. Right after the book of Psalms. Proverbs 4:7. And when you get there, well, I'm just going to say amen for you. All right? All right, speak. And I always tell you to speak the word of God, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. So when you're speaking it, while you're reading it, you're hearing it, and it builds up your faith. So let's speak the word. Ooh, yeah, you got to open your mouth. That's where your power lies. You know, the word said there is power, there's life and death in the power of the tongue. This is a powerful little instrument that you have right here, your mouth. It can open doors for you, or it can close doors for you. You can curse a person, or you can bring blessings on a person. But, you know, that's a whole nother story or program itself about the tongue, because we can talk about the tongue. All right, let's speak. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. That's what I was talking about. I'm getting understanding now about the grace of Jesus Christ. I never had gotten any really information about Him, but I'm getting information, I'm learning about Him, and I'm getting understanding. And it's with it, it's getting within my heart. Hallelujah. But as I've learned more about the gospel of Jesus Christ, grace, the more understanding and revelations I'm receiving, bringing me more freedom spiritually and mentally. I'm developing a deeper and more genuine relationship with my Jesus. I don't know if you heard this song by Tamela Mann, who album went gold. I mean, she's moving. You see her everywhere now. And she said it. She says she's living her destiny. If you get her album, you'll hear what she speaks as she's singing. Because you know, when you speak, you're singing. I mean, when you seek singing, you're speaking also. Hallelujah. Anyway, she says on her song, "I never knew my life could be this way until I found Jesus. I never thought I would be in this place, and I never thought I would be in this place either." She also says, "Reach for your blessings and miracles." All you have to do, young people, is give your life to Jesus and become a disciple. Go with me to Matthew 6:33. Matthew 6:33, that's the New Testament, the beginning of the New Testament. They say that's the New Testament. I say the New Testament starts in Acts. But, you know, those religious people say what they say, and I say what the Lord tell me to say. So I'm saying it starts in the book of Acts when the Holy Spirit came. Hallelujah. Jesus had went and He died and ascended to heaven. He sent the Holy Spirit because He said He would not leave us comfortless. Well, in the book of Acts is where they had the Pentecost, where they were sitting there and they was waiting for the Holy Spirit to come, and He came with a roaring wind. Hallelujah. Awesome. Matthew 6:33. Okay. If you're there, speak. "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you." So if you're reaching for your blessings and your miracles, give your life to Jesus Christ and become a disciple. And as the word says, seek first the kingdom of God. Seek Jesus first while he may be found. And his righteousness and all these things will be added unto you. Get your blessings today, young people. In John 6:29, it says, all our fathers want is for you to trust, believe, and receive his word. Break free today, young people. It may be a little uncomfortable at first. It's a process. Nothing happens overnight, and I'm a living witness to that. But there is nothing like having Jesus in your life. Amen? As for me, young people, this place is that I'm truly in the arms of my Jesus. I'm receiving my blessings and miracles each day he wakes me, because it's a miracle that I'm woke, that he wakes me that morning, each morning. Because my first experience of dealing with a person dying in their sleep was with my stepfather. And you can lay down and go to sleep and you think you're going to wake up in the morning, because I know I say, I thank you for your mercy and that you will wake me in the morning in my right mind and my body functioning fine. But you don't necessarily have to wake up. So every day being woke up when the Lord wakes you up, that's a blessing. And that's actually a miracle too. You know, I just always wonder about at night when you're asleep and you're just dead to the world. And who watching over you? The Holy Spirit watching over you. Hallelujah. But it's appointed time. Everybody has an appointed time, and you may go in your sleep. That's why I say when you wake in the morning, thank you, Father. Thank you, because you don't have to wake up. Hallelujah. And when he wakes me up, that's first, and everything else throughout the day becomes secondary. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. I'm so glad I'm living my life in this place. Because through the gospel, the grace of Jesus Christ, I'm truly becoming free. In fact, I think I'm free. But I still, like I said, it is a process. And it's a learning experience. And I'm still trying to, I don't think I'll ever learn all about grace. Because it's the whole books from Acts with Paul the epistles, the letters of Paul. His grace covers me and his grace holds me up. His grace helps me in all situations that I may have in my life. Hallelujah. Young people, I'm living the best life, the best of my life in this place, in the arms of Jesus. I don't have any more condemnation, guilt, or shame in my life. And it's because I don't live under the laws of Moses of the Old Testament. Today, I'm living my life under the New Covenant. In the New Testament. Go with me to Ephesians 2 and 8. Ephesians 2 and 8 comes right after Galatians in the New Testament. It's not a long book, but it's an extremely powerful book. Ephesians 2 and 8. I think I need to take Paul's advice and start sectioning off the scriptures that I have. But sometimes I get so busy, I just don't have the time. So, okay. Go to Ephesians chapter 2. Turn to Ephesians 2 and 8. Speak. For by grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God. Now go to 9. Not of work, lest any man should boast. Well, you think you done it yourself. You can't earn his love. You can't earn his favor. You can't do nothing. God is in control of it all. Hallelujah. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. I have my own personal trials and tribulations in my life. We all do. But let me give you a couple quick testimonies about my daughter and the car accident I had the other day, Monday. My daughter went into diabetes, and she's on dialysis, and she has some serious issues going on with her because her kidneys does not work at all. Anyway, she slammed her hand in the car door, and from that, it took a minute, but from that, and actually it happened real fast because it's only been maybe 2 or 3 months ago that she did that. But then her fingers start turning black. And when your fingers start turning black, that means there's gangrene setting up, and gangrene means it's dying or it's dead. She had to, in the end, it was these two fingers right here, this one and this finger. And they trying to save her thumb. They actually trying to save her whole hand. But this finger, they had to cut off to here, the second digit. And the baby finger also to the second digit. On her thumb, she has an ulcer. And they trying to save this thumb. They took a grafting from on her side of her hand, which I heard is very painful, and put it over that to hope, praying that it heals, and I hope it heals also. She's at home. She's been in the hospital for the last 12 days. But what the testimony about this is, I remember a time when my daughter would come to me and talk to me about what's going on with her, and I told her, I can't heal you. I have nothing but the Lord to give to you. And she didn't want the Lord. She didn't want nothing. She didn't want me to pray for her. Her faith was gone because in the beginning she would read the scriptures. I would give her healing scriptures and everything. But I guess the healing didn't happen fast enough. And everything that was going on with her kept looking at the circumstances and seeing that she wasn't getting any better. So now she done lost these fingers. And I don't know how she's dealing with it mentally because I haven't seen her since she's been out the hospital. She's been at home and she's been asleep. But I do know this, God's grace is sufficient. She is at home and her fingers are looking absolutely wonderful from what I've seen. She's worried and concerned about that they go, you know, it's an old saying with diabetics that once they start cutting, they keep cutting. No, they don't have to. You just have to have faith and speak. I say speak life and wholeness in your fingers, in your hand, in your body, in your mind. You have to do that yourself. Just speak it with your mouth. I speak life and wholeness within me. And let her, you know, just build her faith up from that. And so what got me is when I went out to the hospital this time, going to see her, is I would say speak with his stripes, you are healed. Personalize it. And it was so funny to me because she spoke it and said it herself. I didn't even have to finish the sentence. And I told her, speak life and healing. And that's what she'd been doing. So now she's getting her faith, I guess, whatever was going on with her fingers, it was messing with her mind because I remember when she looked at her hand and seeing that they were gone, the way she looked, because it was like it wasn't real. Even though she knew it was going to happen. Well, now her faith is there. She has faith because the Lord brought her through. She's at home. She's still alive, you know, because you go through surgery. And she was out almost 7 or 8 hours in surgery getting those fingers, you know, going to pre-op, post-op, whatever. She was in surgery quite a while, but she came through. And now when I talk to her and speak to her, she speaks it now. So, you know, you just have to hold your faith and not look at your circumstances because your circumstances will have you believing, oh, ain't nothing happening. But it is. God gave us doctors too. And those fingers had to go. Otherwise, it would have put infection in her hand and it would have went up in her arm and she would have lost her whole arm. So, see, she realized the blessing, the grace that she received from the Lord because she still has she has her hand and she has 3 of her fingers and she still has her arm. So God is good. And then for myself, I was going to the hospital to see her and I was sitting at the light at the corner of Martin Luther King and between Martin Luther King and North Saginaw Street. Right there, I think, by Chippewa, Root Street. One of those streets. Just sitting there waiting at the light for it to change, for the people to move. Next thing, I'm sitting there and I'm listening to this song called Grace by Ricky Dillard. That's an awesome CD, if you ever can get it. It's just Grace. I think the title song on it is awesome. But the whole CD is awesome to me. And I'm just listening there and I'm bopping, doing my little thing in the car. Next thing I heard something go boom. And then my car hit, well, moved up and hit this other guy's car. And so I'm sitting there, just my head went down. I couldn't let my head back up, couldn't hold it. It was all such a very overwhelming affair. I cried. I couldn't understand why I was crying like I did and couldn't stop crying. But they called the ambulance for me, and the ambulance attendants told me it's because I'm in shock and stressing. And see, I had a heart attack last year. I don't need to be no stressing at all. Anyway, the young man that hit my car, he's a college student. He's praying. He just, I'm so sorry. I'm so this and I'm so that, you know. And I'm not really want to hear this. And then I'm asking him if he got insurance. He didn't have insurance. He said his mom had the insurance on the car, but she never showed up. The truck that I hit in front of me had no damage. It was only my car that got damaged. And it was damaged up in the front and at the back bumper. His car had some, you know, where he hit the car on his bumper, and it probably cracked too. You just got to really look at it, because them little bitty cracks is in there is what moves and tears up the whole bumper. But through it all, I'm sitting there, and I told Paul today, I said, when he hit me, I kind of lost my Jesus in me, because I started saying to him, didn't you see this big old black car? You know, but what he was doing, he was looking at the light. And when the light turned green, he just gunned and took off. He didn't look down. I see young drivers, they sometimes are very scary. I don't like to be around them. I don't even like to ride with them, because they have nerve enough to get a phone ring and they'll start texting and driving. Not with me in the car. No, they don't too much. My grandchildren and stuff, no, they don't care for me to be in the car with them, because I will not let them text and drive with me in there. What you do is on your own, but I be trying to tell them it's too dangerous for you to do that. But anyway, he wasn't texting anything. He was, as far as I know, he said he seen the light change green and he just took off. But when he took off, he hit me and then I hit another car. But through it all, I'm fine so far. I am going to the doctor to see about my neck, because I couldn't hold my head up when it happened. And they wanted me to go to the hospital, but I refused to go to the hospital. I just wasn't going to go. As I said, I kept getting stronger and stronger. That's his grace. grace, power, healing power. Hallelujah. Thank you. Anyway, I tried to talk to the young man and help him calm down, because he was out of it throughout it all. Because he's going to be in a little, have some problems. But, you know, I told him to turn it over to the Lord and let the Lord handle it. Anyway, I got home and everything. And like I said, I was stronger. And for the last couple of days, I've been all right. I only got 3 minutes, Paul. Jesus, you've been letting me go over too far. You know I ain't supposed to do number up to 5 minutes. Okay, let me run my mouth. And then I'm going to be done. I can't get my salvation prayer in today because I don't have time. But anyway, I threw it all. The Lord blessed me. I got a car, a rental car. The insurance I have is taking care of everything. And I haven't had it very long. That was one of the concerns I had, because I just had got that insurance in January. But through it all, I'm working and I'm still riding. I'm not missing a beat. And like I said, I'm going to go see about my neck, but I know it's going to be okay, because my Lord, I speak life and healing in my body and in my mind. I'm going to have to stop right now. And I'm going to just run to the salvation prayer right quick. Do I got time, Paul? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, 3 minutes.
Okay, that's my testimony for me and my daughter. And, you know, it's like, I don't know what somebody may be going through, but they need to know or hear what I'm saying. And you know, you go, God is good. That's all I can say. He is good, and his mercy endures forever. And his grace is sufficient in it all. Hallelujah. I got off my subject, but I just had to say what was in my heart on that, because it's been like I said, it's been an extremely busy week. And a lot of health things, issues have happened, accidents and babies losing, my baby losing her fingers and everything, but all is good. As he said, all is well. Hallelujah. Okay, let me leave this alone and get to this. Do you genuinely want to meet Jesus today and be free, made free through his grace, which is his unmerited favor? For you to be saved, made free, and meet Jesus, all you have to do is accept his free gift of salvation and become a disciple. This is your time to make a decision. I'm telling you, young people, don't wait until tomorrow, because tomorrow might be too late. And I can't help speaking that more and more. So speak this prayer of salvation with me and begin a whole new, wonderful, blessed life in Jesus Christ. And put your hand across your heart, you know, like you're going to make a pledge of allegiance, because this is a commitment. Once you get in it, you're in it. How I'm doing, Paul?
You got 2 minutes.
Okay. Speak. My Lord Jesus Christ, I repent of my sins, asking for forgiveness. Come into my heart with your unmerited grace of favor. I believe in all my heart, and I confess with my mouth that I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and I believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead and that I will be saved. You are now the Lord and Savior of my life. Thank you, my Lord, for saving me, Jesus. Amen. This came from Romans 10 and 9 with some paraphrasing from me. And that's all it takes, young people. You are now a child of God. The Holy Spirit is now also alive within you. Now, I want you to remember, the devil's going to attack. It's not going to be peaches and cream like some people think, that once they give their life to the Lord, everything is going to be fine. Nope. The devil's coming for you. He didn't have to before because he had you. So I'm telling you to get ready for the battle and speak Ephesians 10 and 18 daily, covering yourself by putting on the whole armor of God. And remember always, it's not your battle, it's the Lord's. There's nobody like Jesus. His blessings are up on you. Now begin to praise him. He is leading you right now. Renew your mind by speaking, studying, and meditating on our Father's word daily. Develop a relationship with him. Find a Holy Spirit-filled grace teaching church and get involved. Until next time, let the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ be up on you, and our Lord's grace and peace be with you, and his countenance shine up on you always. Amen.
Uh-huh. But God will get his glory. That's right. Now what we see, lies never true. It's what he do.